Now, not everyone has the money or the budget to spend $250 on a pair of football boots, which is what the top of the line Phantom GT would cost. Below that, you have the Pro model, which retails for $120, and below that, you have the Phantom GT Academy low, which retails for $80. But what if you want a DF collar? Well, you can spend an extra $5 and buy this boot right here, the Nike Phantom GT Academy DF, which of course includes a collar, retails for $85. And from a quality perspective, it's nothing more than just okay. And that's kind of the thing with takedown models. When you're talking about top-end boots, they tend to be pretty good across the board, but with takedowns, there's a ton of variation from one boot to the next. And in the case of the Phantom GT Academy, it's okay in some ways, it's kind of cheap in other ways. And I want to highlight all of those details for you today in this review, including how they fit and feel on feet. So if you're interested in learning more and really determining whether or not these are even worth the $85 price tag, please stick around, watch the entire video. And if you're interested in a pair for yourself, I'll leave a little pop-up on screen, or you can click the first link down below. That's gonna take you to the review page on my website, where you'll find buy it now links with exclusive SR4U coupon codes, where you'll be able to pick these up below their normal $85 retail price. Also, if you guys do end up enjoying this video and would like to see me review more takedown model football boots on the channel, don't forget to support this one with a like. And if you're new here watching for the first time and don't wanna miss out on weekly content on everything football boots, make sure you hit that subscribe button. Now, before we get into performance or technical details, I just want to quickly address two things that I often see in the comment section whenever I review takedown models, and that is, one, it's the player, not the boots. I wholeheartedly agree with that. I never said that higher end or more expensive football boots will make you play better, because they quite simply will not. And then two, the boots are not that bad. And that is, to a point, true, but you clicked on a review video of an $85 football boot. I'm gonna tell you what is objectively good and what is objectively bad. If you're expecting a takedown model to be a 10 out of 10 perfect, I'm sorry to disappoint you, but there is no true 10 out of 10, not even from top end models, let alone a takedown. Now, from a performance perspective, it's important to note what the Phantom GT as a line actually replaces, because that kind of sets the standard for whether or not Nike has done a good or bad job with the Phantom GT Academy. Now, the Phantom GT takes over for the Phantom Venom and the Phantom Vision line, where you had, of course, the Phantom Venom Academy, as well as most recently the Phantom Vision 2 Academy, which were actually both pretty decent takedown models at the $80 price point. These are $85, so I would hope for that extra $5, they've given you something that is at the very least just as good, if not more premium. And unfortunately, I don't think that these are an upgrade at all over the two boots that I mentioned. I think that those are just a little bit better from a quality perspective, at least when you're talking about the upper, because as you can see, this is not a Flyknit upper. It's a very cheap synthetic. It's not the same Nike skin mesh base material that we saw on the previous models that I just mentioned. So while it's flexible, while it feels fine on feet, it's just on the cheaper side in terms of what you're gonna find from football boots at this price point. It does have technically generative texture in the form of some little kind of dimples that run across the entire upper, trying to mimic what you're gonna find on the top end model, but they're not as sharp, they're not as prominent. It's something that is a lot less noticeable on the ball in general. And as a whole, this is a very similar synthetic to what you're gonna find on the current Nike Mercurial Vapor 13 Academy model, which is, again, kind of just so-so in terms of quality. It's not to say that these won't get the job done, because they absolutely will, but as far as takedown models from Nike and really takedown models at this price point is concerned, this is a pretty subpar upper. Just like the more expensive models in the Phantom GT line, you'll find that the lacing system is offset, pushed to the lateral side of the boot, leaving you with this very clean surface to strike the ball. However, because there's now so much surface area with no lacing system, you're gonna find that when you combine this off-centered lacing system with this cheaper synthetic upper, when the boots are on feet, especially when they're brand new and the material is a little bit stiffer at first, you get some really ugly creases and bulges. It's not necessarily an issue, but it's certainly not the most elegant thing in the world. And Nike, like I said, has done better in the past as far as the quality of material is concerned. Had this been the same Nike skin that we had on either the Phantom Vision 2 Academy or the Phantom Venom Academy, this boot and this design, I just think, would have worked a lot better. So I'm a little bit confused as to why they didn't go with that material. Again, this just feels and looks a lot cheaper. far as the central portion of this lacing system is concerned, you can see it's filled in. It looks like it's kind of like a one-piece upper. It's not. It's actually just filled in with the same kind of stretchy, almost neoprene material that the collar is made out of, but it's not actually attached on the underside of the upper. It just kind of floats in the middle and then is attached at the very base. So it's separate, and when you put them on, it's immediately noticeable because it kind of folds up and bunches awkwardly, so you have to play around with it before you tie the laces, unless you just want these kind of creases on top of your foot, which nobody does. It's a very similar design to what we've previously seen from Adidas on the X17.3, for those that remember that design. Wasn't a big fan of those. I'm not a huge fan of the way they did this one either. And then as far as the DF collar is concerned, you are paying an extra $5 for this, and quite frankly, it's not worth it. Changes up the construction in the heel a little bit versus the low cut variation of this boot, which I think makes for a worse fit, and they're just not as comfortable. And then as far as the collar itself is concerned, it is an upgrade over, I guess, the more very cheap sock-like material we have previously seen on a lot of Nike's mid-cut takedown models. So this feels a little bit better, but in general, it's literally just some extra material around the bottom of your ankle. Does nothing other than just give the boot a mid-cut look. And as far as the ankle support arguers are concerned, I have for you this tag right here, which actually comes with the boot. Nike has actually been including these for a long time. You can see it says Nike Dynamic Fit. That's why this is the DF model. That's effectively what DF means. It's the mid-cut design of this boot. And you can see on the backside, pause the video right there if it focuses, but I'm going to read it for you. It says, the Dynamic Fit collar creates a seamless integration between the boot and lower leg. In other words, it's not an ankle support element, it's literally just some material around your ankle. Internally, you're gonna find a ton of mesh. It's a black mesh liner with a decent amount of padding, so it's not uncomfortable or anything like that, although the lining material, depending on what socks you're wearing, can be a little bit slick. Then the insole is fully glued in. It too is lined in a mesh material and just seems to be made from a single layer of this blue colored foam. Pretty typical for takedown models, although again, in the past from Nike at this price point, we have seen removable insoles. So that is a little bit of a downgrade in terms of overall quality. Moving to the base, this is where I think Nike has actually done a really good job, and this is a legit improvement over the models that this replaces. It is a design variation of the HyperQuick sole plate and stud pattern found on the Top End Elite model, and honestly, doesn't feel too far off of that. For an $80 price point takedown model, this is well above average and actually feels quite premium. And for me, that's a big deal with a lot of these cheaper takedown models. The sole plates end up feeling really cheap and you can't really save the boot from there. Having a nice solid base is super important, and this definitely has that, where you kind of have a split sole design with a stud plate in the forefoot as well as in the heel, but it's technically connected with the stiffener bar running on the lateral side, which again is a design element that gives it this very good freedom to kind of torque with the natural bend of your foot that I just think feels very good. So really happy with the way that they designed this. And of course, filling in the central portion where it looks like it's split, there still is an internal sole plate. This is basically just to house the studs. As far as the studs themselves are concerned, you'll notice that they are different from the Elite models in the FG variation. And that's because this is not an FG stud pattern. As we've previously seen on Academy tier models from Nike, this is an MG stud pattern, which stands for multi-ground. So basically what changes is all of the studs that would normally be bladed, or in the case of the Phantom GT, where they're kind of round, but then split down the middle and then slid in either direction. You can see they're pretty much just conical studs. They maintained a little bit of that design element, sort of, but for the most part, it's conical studs with some blades at the tip of the toe, a bladed support stud, and some blades in the heel. Otherwise, this is very similar to Nike's AG Pro stud pattern, which is fine because it still works really good on firm natural grass, but you can also use this on an AG artificial grass surface. So for the application of wearing this on pretty much any surface you need to, not only is the traction gonna be good, not only are the boots gonna be safe in terms of just not increasing your risk of injury, but they also should hold up pretty well from a durability perspective. Which brings us to the weight, where I have to say I'm a little bit confused by what Nike have done here, because when I picked them up for the first time, I was pleasantly surprised with how light they are. So pleasantly surprised that I was maybe a little bit confused as to why they felt slightly lighter than the Top End Elite model. So, in a size 9.5 US, you can see that the Phantom GT Academy DF weighs in at 7.35 ounces, the equivalent of 208 grams, which in comparison to the Elite model is roughly about 0.3 to 0.4 ounces lighter. Not a huge difference, but it's kind of a little bit strange for the $85 version of a boot to be lighter than the $250 or $275 boot within the same line. Regardless of that information, these boots are pretty light. So as you can see, I've swapped out the stock black laces, which look fine. They're mostly black boots, but I've changed them for some neon pink reflective SR4U replacement laces, which add the reflective bits, plus the pink just matches all the details on the boots. And I think that makes this colorway honestly pop really nicely. It's also a great way of changing up the style of your football boots in a very inexpensive way. If you're interested in some replacement laces for yourself, the website to go to is www.sr4ulaces.com. There'll be a little pop-up on screen as well as a link down below in the description. So if you're interested in some for yourself, be sure to go ahead and check that out. On feet, the boots feel fine, but I can tell you that they are quite a ways off the Elite model in terms of overall fit and feel. The upper, as I mentioned earlier, is on the cheaper side as far as synthetics go, and you can see as you bend your foot, you get some really significant creases and bulges in this area free of the laces, which isn't unlike the top-end Elite model, but this material in general is just a lot less pliable, so they're not as comfortable in terms of having the material kind of dig into your foot ever so slightly, but as it softens up with wear time, it does get a lot better. And from a structure standpoint, it does feel relatively secure on foot once you tie the laces tight. So they're gonna have a nice responsive sensation, all things considered. And the lacing system seems to do a pretty good job of holding your foot in place, despite the ugly creases. As far as the heel area is concerned with the DF design, it's not my favorite in terms of shaping or fit, but it feels all right, so no major complaints there. And then the sole plate and stud pattern, as I mentioned, is above average for a football boot at this price point. So that as a base, feels quite solid. As far as fit is concerned, the Elite model fits very wide. This is not nearly as wide as the Elite model, and a lot of that is down to the material. It doesn't seem to be quite the same shape. I'm not gonna say that if you had wide feet, these wouldn't fit you, but they are nowhere near as wide as the top end model. I would personally suggest that if you had really wide feet, these might not be the best option for you, which is a little bit strange because you'd expect the fit to be at least somewhat similar across the entire line, but these in general just seem to fit a lot tighter than the top end Elite models. And as far as sizing is concerned, also unlike the Elites, these definitely do run true to size. So I'm wearing these in my usual size 9.5 US, and the fit and the length is perfect. So if you're looking to order a pair for yourself, I would strongly recommend going true to size in order to achieve the best possible fit. So in conclusion, the $85 Phantom GT Academy DF from Nike is nothing more than okay. It's not so bad that I can't recommend them, but it's not so good that I would recommend them, if that makes any sense. If we're comparing this to the two models that it replaces, the Phantom Venom Academy and the Phantom Vision 2 Academy, I feel like both of those boots, especially when you're talking about the uppers, were far superior and just felt better on feet. This sole plate is an improvement over both of those, but the upper definitely feels like a step down. And if we're comparing this to all the other Academy tier options within Nike's now three boot lineup, Mercurial, Tiempo, and Phantom GT, I'd have to put this in third place. It's kind of the same, or at least a very similar type of synthetic to what you're gonna find on the Academy tier Mercurial, minus the extra texturing, of course, but because of the central lacing system on that boot, I just feel like it fits better, and overall, it's more comfortable. And honestly, in terms of bang for your buck, the best value for around $80, technically less than that, would be the Tiempo Legend 8 Academy. It's just a really solid boot. You can never go wrong with natural leather at the lower price points. But if you're a fan of synthetic uppers and you don't have a lot of money to spend, I would definitely recommend taking a look at the Phantom Vision 2 Academy and the Phantom Venom Academy that is now on sale. They're just better football boots. Anyways, guys, that's it for my review. Hopefully you enjoyed the video. If you did, be sure to support it with a like. Again, if you're interested in a pair of these for yourself, first link down below, that's gonna take you to the review page on my website, where you'll find buy it now links with exclusive SR4U coupon codes, where you'll be able to pick these up below their normal $85 retail price. If you have any questions, as always, feel free to ask them down below in the comment section, and I'll do my best to get an answer out to you. If you aren't subscribed to the channel already, make make sure you hit that subscribe button along with the little bell notification so you get notified when the next new video goes live. You can find all my social media information linked down below in the description as well. And other than that, guys, thank you so much for watching, and we'll see you in the next one.